The wicked Amalek traveled twice away in order cannot be, you cannot grow. You cannot grow in any way without Jesus. Jesus is the vine, and we are the branches. Unless the branches tap from the vine, the trunk, the branches, they wither. Unless the branches, they suck the milk of the trunk, they dry up. Unless we are in Christ and He is in us, we will bear no fruit. Our Christianity will be for nothing. I want you to know that whatsoever God has given you is a seed. Your salvation is a seed. You are only God the fruit. Your baptism of the Holy Spirit is a seed. You are only God the fruit. Whatsoever God has given you as a Christian is a seed. And if you make it to remain a seed, on the day of judgment, God will ask you why. That is why as a Christian, you must grow. As a Christian, you are a seed. You must be planted. You must be attached to the vine. You must suck the milk every day. You must eat the word of God every day. The book of 2 Peter, chapter 1, from verse 3, says, "And God is divine power, and given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness." All things that pertain unto this life that we are living, and to godliness. All things that we need to exhibit as a child for God is given to us. All things to manifest godliness in our life, that is to say, we are God on this earth. The things that make God to wonder, why is your thing so different, so different? Why do you behave in a different manner? Has been given unto you as a seed. He said, through the knowledge of Him that has called us to glory and virtue. When God calls you, He gives you a seed. A seed to have the knowledge of His Son. He said, "Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by this you might be partakers of the divine nature, the nature of God." When God gives you a seed, the seed will not do it by itself. You have to plant the seed. No matter how important a seed is, a seed must be planted, and when the seed grows, it must produce after its own kind. Every seed produces after its own kind. When the word of God comes to you as a seed, the Bible says Jesus Himself is the word. You plant it in your own life, it becomes Jesus. It's not become Satan. It's not become witch. Become anything else, but it becomes Jesus. He said, "We are back by giving unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by this you might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. And besides this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue." Add to your faith. He said, after faith, faith is not everything. Stop. Without love, faith. fruit